On this class, guys, we are going to talk about Seller Hub and why it's so important for you to save this page and operate from this page, because from this page you will be able to access to everything in your eBay store, okay? So it's very important for you to be using that since the beginning. I will leave the link for you guys. You have to opt in for a first time. You will see that you are not able to access to Seller Hub. Maybe they will not allow you to access to your Seller Hub until you list your first item. And the only thing you have to do in that case is just come to ebay.com and hold here where it says my eBay and click on selling. Okay, so you will be accessing to a different page, not the Seller Hub, where you will be able to list your first item. You will see somewhere in that website a link where it says create listing, and that is the only thing you have to do. You just have to list an item in order to be able to access to your seller hub. Okay, so just look for some item like Samsung Galaxy S6 or something like that. Okay, and say that you wanna Samsung Galaxy 6, and say that you want to sell. Yeah, exactly. It's just like this, and select one to sell in your shop. Okay, use this product. Exactly. So you can click on use this product, then you can list the same product in your shop. It already comes with a price, with a title, so you don't have to change anything, but at least you can list this item on your shop. And that's what we want, actually. Okay, you will have to add business policies for sure. The mail address, there is a link to a PayPal account. Okay, sorry guys, this is not account that I, yeah, this is another seller account that I don't have configured. But in any case, yeah, just after solving these errors, if it displays any errors, you will be able to list your first item. Okay, you don't need to spend a lot of time here. Just set all the things that they require for you to list the item, and once it's done, you will be able to access to this URL that I just left for you attached to the class. Okay, so once you're done with that, you will be able to access to your Seller Hub, where you will always see the name of your shop here and the number of reviews that you got from buyers, from clients. Okay, this is a new account, so it will look like this when you just start. Okay, first thing I want you to do is just click on here on customize and select every option here, because it's interesting. Yeah, I highly recommend you to check off every option here to show every a box that is gonna provide information about your seller account. Okay, and when you stop customizing, when you stop adding all of them, I highly recommend you to order them by, you know, the tasks is the first one that I recommend you to put right here. Your sales is the second one. And then can be promotional offers. That's has important information. We are gonna talk about that in a moment. Monthly limits, that's important too. Account summary is very important. And the feedback that you are getting from buyers, from clients. All this about orders, listings, shortcuts. I never really take a look at that much on these boxes, but I'm gonna explain why these six first boxes are so important. Okay, first thing are the tasks. Okay, because in the tasks you are gonna see messages about, yeah, you just have to click stop customizing when you are done. Under the tasks box, you will see everything that you need to do, and sometimes you will see these messages under a red color. Okay, and that implies that this message is going to be urgent and you will have to take actions soon on there. Okay, so eBay is always letting you know about what you have to do next, about processing orders, about processing returns, about everything that you can imagine, okay, in your account. The sales box is also important because it's telling you how many sales you had today, on the last 7 days, on the last 31 days, last 90 days. Okay, so you will be selling here on the graphs some, just sales on eBay. I will show you the example. Yeah, exactly, something like this. Okay, you will be seeing something like this when you start making good sales, something like this. Something like this, exactly. You will see something like this at first, some sales, but not every day. So yeah, little by little. And then well, so this is important. Yeah, I like it to, just to see how many sales I'm getting currently. That is important. Okay, these are the promotional offers, and when you start a shop on eBay, when you start as a new seller, you are gonna have, and this is important for you always to check, okay, you are gonna have 50 items that you can list on your shop for free, okay? That means you can list up to 50 items per month, all right? And that's all. You can start from there. So you can start listing up to 50 items per month and play with that without the need to pay anything to eBay at all. Okay, I will show you how many subscriptions there are for shops, for eBay shops, in order to get more listings, but that will be in another class. Okay, this is very important because whenever you list an item on your eBay shop, it will say, okay, used one, left 49. Okay, if you list your first item, but if you delete that item, this will not count on here. Okay, that means if you just delete this item and then you replace it with a new one, that will be two of them here. Okay, so make sure you just don't go over 50 on here by using over 50 on here, because every single item that you list after having your first 50 items, you will have to pay for it. Okay, you will have to pay 30 cents of a dollar for every single item that you list after your promotional limits. All right, that is important. These are the monthly limits. In the past, when you used to create a eBay account, it used to say like 10 items or 100 items, but for some reason, now when you create a new account on eBay, and I hope you are lucky enough like I am, it always says in the monthly limits that you have up to 2 billion more items to list. This will change when you list your first items. This will change to 100,000 items, which is still amazing. It means that you don't have limits. You don't really have limits. You can list as many items as you want. It's just that, as I told you before, you will be paying for that after the first free items that you have, according to your promotional offers or to the shop that you are subscribed on. Okay, but the great things is that, yeah, you put the limit after all. I mean, if you want to pay for extra items, then you have list you can list as many as you want, and which is, yeah, totally amazing on these times. Yeah, I'm very happy that they changed this policy. And okay, this is another important box, because you will be seeing here the current balance, which is not the money that you get, it's the money that eBay is gonna charge you. Okay, now it says zero, but imagine that I list my first 50 items, and I list not 50 but 55. Then you will see some money charged on here, because I just listed 5 items, and they will be charging, as I told you before, 30 cents per item. So you will be seeing at all time how much money you owe to eBay. Okay, if you subscribe for a shop, if you list more items than the ones you got for free, everything that you had to pay to eBay, including the sales, because every time you got a sale, eBay gets a commission from there. They got about 10% or 9%, depending on in if you have a shop or not. Okay, I will tell about that later. But everything that you had to pay on eBay, you will see it here. And believe me, you better be checking this from time to time, just to make sure you don't get surprises. Okay, that should be good. And last thing, yeah, here is the feedback. You will be getting positive feedbacks. It's not very complicated to get positive feedbacks on eBay, so you will be seeing that yeah, this will increase after you got your first sales, okay? So people will be leaving positive feedback, and you can check here if they leave neutral or even negative feedback, so you can, you know, contact the buyer, ask them why they just leave a negative feedback, ask them if you can do something for them in order to remove that negative feedback, something like that, okay? We will deal with that in another course about customer service. And that should be all. That's all that I wanted to, well, yeah, you got a box about orders, you got a box about listings, and yeah, but I just want you to know that you can access to everything from here, including, you know, you got the overview just to access to this page, but then you got the everything about orders. You can see all your orders, those that are awaiting for payment. You know, as I told you in the last class, sometimes buyers or clients purchase for a product but they don't pay it. So yeah, that this window will be for those who still didn't pay for the items, which is not our concern at all. You know, we don't need to worry about these ones. Awaiting shipment, yeah, that will mean that those that are here are the ones that, you know, you will be seeing the ones that the sales that you got from some sellers, and then cancellations, returns, cases, that is important too. We will see about that in the customer service course. And the listings is are also important. You know, if you click on here and go to active listings, you will see the full list of your items here. And you will be able to order them by custom, by current price, or by, you know, depending on the file here. But we will see that in another class. Okay, so and the last thing I want you to see is your performance, because it can help you a lot to check how you are doing on your sales. Well, this is not really important actually, because you can say your sales here, but what is important, it's the marketing, because that allows you to promote your active listings, to advertise your active listings, you know, in the way that you can, eBay can promote those listings, and they will be charging 1% or 2% on the sale, depending on how you set up that, okay? And I think that should be all for now, okay? Yeah, we can come into the end of this class and keep going on the next one, where I'm gonna explain you guys about the subscription to the shops.